please come back to your seat, Delta.
Tower 9 Tango, contact tower 18.5, goodbye.
The race to reduce carbon emissions from air travel has seen multiple milestones this year, with two companies having completed successful test flights of hydrogen-powered aircrafts. UK startup ZeroAvia said it successfully conducted a test flight of a hydrogen-powered 19-seater plane in January, and in March, a universal hydrogen plane equipped with the largest hydrogen fuel cell ever to power an aircraft had a successful 15-minute flight of a modified Dash 8 aircraft in Washington State.
It is the beginning of a flight test campaign that will ultimately culminate in a 2025 entry into passenger service of 50 to 60 seat regional airplanes, starting with the ATR 72.
The Paris Agreement has a goal of net zero emission air travel by 2050, and hydrogen powered planes present one of the most promising options.
So aviation is one of the few sectors that's actually forecasted to grow in emissions on the time horizon of the Paris Agreement by 2050. So hydrogen probably represents the best and only hope the sector really has to make a meaningful dent, right, enough to offset continuing traffic growth. The only alternative we as an industry have is curtailing traffic volumes in order to reduce emissions.
Connect Airlines, which operates regional flights between Toronto and Chicago and Philadelphia, has already placed an order to convert 75 planes to hydrogen power through Universal Hydrogen, and Air New Zealand is working with a series of partners as it looks to make its aircraft fleet zero emission. However, several hurdles remain, including how best to transport the hydrogen and space limitations of the hydrogen modules aboard the aircrafts. But these test flights present a promising step in the right direction as airlines work towards reduced emissions. Steve Rappaport, Bloomberg News.